So hi everybody, apologies for the slight delay. I have to say it's really nice being here. It's my second time in Japan, and DBCLS is involved in both visits because the first one was for the first biohackathon back in 2008, and I'm really grateful for this. For me today it's a challenge. I'm presenting to you the Species 800 corpus. Usually this work that took place in 2012 is presented in a broader context and gets maximum 2-3 slides. So it's a challenge presenting to you more specific details, and I hope it will lead to nice follow-up discussions. We are working with basic literature mining tools, so named entity recognition. And we will see today about the recognition of species names in text, meaning Linnaean binomials, common species names, vernacular names, shorthand forms, for example, when you keep the first letter of the genus and you follow the subspecies, and author-derived abbreviations. Knowing the species mentioned in text is a key component for many downstream purposes. First of all, in a biomedical context for gene-protein name recognition, so you want to know if your protein is the human or the rat homolog. And just to give you an example of how extreme it can get, although this is not a fair example, I was just querying NTRES gene for cyclone C oxidase subunit 1, so for COX-1. In October 2012, I was getting sequences related to more than 3,500 species, and now it's over 6,400 species. Although I say it's not very fair because this gene is meant to distinguish one species from the other. It can be used for document clustering, and so follow-up search and retrieval approaches. You may have a collection of documents, and you may find the document related to primates or to rodents, although those terms may not be mentioned, but the species names are mentioned instead. It's very important when you are developing such system to have a strategy on how to benchmark them. There are two aspects you can benchmark. One is the speed, and this is a bit straightforward. You use a speedometer. You don't care about kilometers per hour or miles per hour, but in text mining you may have to count Pavlov abstracts per second to find the speed. The less straightforward is the accuracy, and this is why gold standard corpora are needed. When we were conducting this, when we were starting this work on the species target, Linnaeus, and I'm very happy that Goran is here attending. The Linnaeus software and the Linnaeus corpus, they were out. Linnaeus is a corpus that comprises 100 annotated full-text articles, and as it is full-text articles, it is implicit that some species names that an article relates to get repeated many times. So we wanted to go a little bit away from this high degree of repetition that lowers the diversity. And in order to benchmark the system we were developing, a species target, to have an approach that would increase diversity and provide us with options of insight, for example, to see how species names occur in different scientific fields. This gave rise to the S800, the Species 800 corpus, that comprises 800 manually annotated PubMed abstracts, and we went a step further. We didn't just choose these abstracts randomly. We went to the Thomson Scientific and collected journals representative of different fields, like general bacteriology for bacteriology, or fungal genetics and biology for mycology, because we wanted to have abstracts that correspond to different scientific fields. Of course, medicine is in there, but that was like a control, because we expect not to find many names there, so we wanted to be able to test for false positives. After the abstracts were collected, there was a curation task, so we had five curators from master's to postdoc level, which had to go through all the text and find all species names mentioned and map them to the NCBI taxonomy, so as to be able to assess the normalization event. And they marked down linear binomials, common names, day names, defined acronyms, misspellings, typos, and other kind of species names. I just added a few information here following on yesterday's dinner discussion. The 800 abstracts were divided evenly to the five curators. So every curator was given 160 abstracts. And then they were also retrieving another 32 shared with the other annotators. That gave us the possibility of calculating the inter-annotator agreement, which was 0.8. Results. So in comparison to the Linnaeus corpus, let's say the same curation effort, more or less at the same number of mentions, we had three times as many species. And here is a graph that shows the precision and recall for each category. So for the abstract filanders in different journals, it's the Linnaeus tiger and the species tiger. Both tigers have similar performance, but what you can observe here is you can see like in like periology or mycology, well, most probably the researchers are using the Linnaean binomials, organism name, species name recognition becomes better, as for example, opposed to the biology, which is the worst case. The S800 and the species tiger, they are available at the species.hcmr.gr site. Oh, this is the link for the direct download of the corpus. And going a little bit into more technical details in the context of the hackathon, it's organized in a directory that contains the text and a tabular format that contains the annotation. This is available for the overall corpus, but we have also the same structure for each category of abstracts. You have an abstract text, and here I show you the species names I mentioned there. The orange is the one that we have in the public version. The yellow are higher taxa which were tagged by the curators, but they were not released. And the annotation looks somehow like this. It's a tab delimited file. We have the NCBI taxonomy, we have the file name linked to the common abstract. So this is where we reference the common abstract. It's a little bit cryptic. The offset, where the annotation starts and where it ends, and the text that has been curated. S800, since its publication, it has recently been used by Risa and Sophia. I know they are collaborators of some of you in the context of BioCreative for training and evaluation. The intention here on working was on the S800 is convert the tabular format to the pub annotation format, and be able to increase the corpus visibility, so make it easier for others to discover and use. All the work that has been presented today is described in the Species and Organism Research paper. Follow-up on the S800, we've done work on the identification of environment ontology terms, and another corpus was generated there, the E600, comprising encyclopedia flag pages. The same script could be reused there, however, as it involves encyclopedia flag pages, I don't know how applicable it would be to the tab annotation form. Just to close the presentation with a metaphor, I'm working in a lab where we are doing field expeditions and we are collecting polychaete worms out of, for example, lagoon sediment. We have a huge repository of knowledge. Why not to do the same and extract the organisms from there as well? A big thank you to the ACMR team, the curators, and also to my collaborators, Lars and Sune, the Novo Nordisk Foundation Center for Protein Research. Lars has a follow-up presentation later in the day, and we'll provide you, I guess, with more information on the target.